I am the managing director of a business called Elation, and my entire preoccupation is working with small businesses to help them understand how to make their businesses bigger. And that means something different for every business, but there are some universal principles that I think that will be really valuable for you guys to share and understand today. So there are four things that I would intend to happen for you all today. Number one, I want you to understand what are the characteristics of a truly world-class business. Number two, I'm going to teach you the critical principles that will define a world-class business. But most importantly, I'm going to help you to understand how to apply those in your business. And hopefully, you're going to stick around right till the very end of this webinar, because the intention behind the webinar is to give you even more tools, even more tips, even more techniques to master business growth in your organization. And there will be some really great hot seat sessions. And for those of you who listen to the content, for those of you who think, yes, this is what my business needs, by the end of the session, you'll have an opportunity to join a hot seat session to really get inside your own business, to apply the diagnostics to your business, and to really help you to maximise your business growth. But first of all, just a very quick story. I started working in sales and business growth about 20 years ago. I've had an absolutely fantastic career. I've loved every minute of it. And in every one of the roles that I have had, my key preoccupation has always been how to generate more revenue for an organisation. And I've been lucky enough to work with some really serious sales professionals. You know, at my peak, I was managing teams of up to 400 people, and my entire responsibility was making sure that those individuals and the businesses within which they worked maximised the growth of their business. When I set up Elation in 2009, my key mission was to make sure that I shared that experience, was to make sure that I was able to impart to any business, no matter what size or shape that business was, the proven formulas for success that I have witnessed in the businesses that I've worked in. And I found this particularly challenging. But I want to tell you that I've solved the problem, and I want to share with you today exactly how. So let's go through what it is that we are going to talk about today, our agenda for today. First of all, what is a world-class business? How to make your business world-class? How you can find out more about the proven growth framework formula to apply to your business to make sure that you overcome any challenges that you have to growth? And finally, towards the end of the session, we'll talk to you about how you can get a hot seat session, which will teach you specifically how you can implement these ideas in your business. So this is not theoretical. This is about how you apply the world-class principles to the organisation that you work in. But first of all, let's talk a little bit about the problem that we're talking about solving. Everybody who I work with, and most people that I talk to, say that what they are looking for is a more successful business. And the challenge around that is that whilst every business wants to be better, there are very few objective ways of doing that. There's lots of generic advice. And people might say, we want to create a better business. They might be looking at exploring lots of different ways of doing that. They might think, we need to do more training. They might be thinking, we need to get in an expert consultant, a business coach. We might need to get in a marketing consultant, a finance consultant. They might be thinking that they need to invest in management training because they need better leaders to drive their business forward. They might be thinking, we need better systems, we need a better database, we need a better CRM, we need better logging procedures in our organisation. Some disgruntled, frustrated individuals might just be thinking they need a different business. But there are many and various ways that you could choose as a small business person to address the issue of having a more successful business. And this is risky. Because actually, if I've got 10 different options that I can choose from, I can't afford to invest in all of them. I might not necessarily know which is the one that is the most relevant for me to invest in. So I could say, well, I'm going to focus on my website, or I'm going to focus on getting a CRM, or I'm going to look at a finance consultant to come in and talk to me about my forecasting. And all of those could be justifiable business expenses. However, I wanted to create a better option. Yeah, I wanted to create an option that was measurable, that was tangible and could be bespoke for every single business. Yeah, I wanted to ensure that no matter what market you're working in, no matter what you know, what offering you have, what target market you're in, that you could embrace ways of supercharging your business and getting that world-class support in a holistic and an effective way. Because actually, no business can afford a full suite of consultants to work with them. So how can we do this in a really effective way? So number one, we need to think about what does world class mean? We sometimes make a mistake in business where we think to ourselves that world class is something that applies to market leaders. Virgin Airways are world class. Harrods is world class. Could we be world class when we're operating out of our small back bedroom in Bristol? Could we be world class with our team of 20 people in London? Could we be world class with our two part-timers in Wales? Well, absolutely we can. World class is defined as having the highest standards of business performance at a global level. Just means being the best. It just means applying principles of excellence to growing your business. Now, the critical principles that define a world-class business, a business that is of the highest standards, a business that generates the most revenue, a business that has the happiest customers, a business that has the loyalest staff, they are the critical principles that form the framework that Elation operate under. In 2009, following my 20 years experience working in senior level sales, I devised the growth framework, which is a framework that teaches the business everything that it needs to know about becoming world class. It's about building a business of the strongest of its type. It's about, oh, hello, I can see Emma now. Hello, Emma. It's about building a business that is the best at what it does, that outstrips its competitors, that creates a fantastic environment for its staff, and that makes sure that everybody within that business has a powerful foundation for growth. When I hear businesses saying, I want to look at my marketing before we look at growth, I want to look at some coaching before I look at growth, when I hear people saying they want to get their finances in order before they look at growth, I always feel concerned because these things aren't mutually exclusive. We need to look at our organisation as one holistic thing and consider everything that we do around our finance, our marketing, our staffing, everything we do, we need to consider them in line with our growth principles. So applying the growth framework allows us to build a world-class business effectively and simply. Let's talk about the principles which define world-class. World-class businesses get three things right, and always get three things right. Those things are defined under the three pillars of the growth framework, and they are in no particular order. Number one, your business activities, the individual communications that your customer sees, and the way in which that you use those communications to build better relationships, better loyalty, and better customers. The second area that we look at when we're considering the principles of a world-class business is your process. Your process is the steps by which you drive customer attraction to your business. It's how you are efficient and effective. It's the stages that your customers go through when they work with you. And the final area for world-class business is the management. It's the way you track and measure success. It's the way you make sure that your staff are motivated. These three critical principles of a world-class business are all about how you sell more of your offering to more customers. People often think that sales is about the individual interactions that you have with your customers that leads them to buy with you. That's not true. Sales is about everything that your business does to maximize revenue. It's about the communication, it's about the processes, the practices, and it's about the management. That's what I want to talk to you about today. I want you to understand the critical principles of a world-class business, and I want you to understand how you can apply them to your business growth. We're going to look at these three areas of activity, process, and management. We're going to look at how these three areas can really impact, and then we're going to talk in some specific detail about which businesses do this brilliantly and how you can emulate those businesses. So we've got three case studies coming up. I want you to think about how does your business compare. So, think first of all about powerful process. A really powerful sales process is about the steps that your customers take when they move through your organisation. It's about the specific experience that people have when they work with your organisation. Now, I want to talk to you about an organisation you might have heard of who have absolutely maximised the process in their business and have done so very powerfully and effectively. An organisation you might all have heard of called Apple. Now, Apple have created the world's best-selling mobile phone. Now, that in itself is a very interesting statistic, but I want you to stop and think about that for a minute. The Apple iPhone is the most expensive phone on the market currently, and yet it outsells every other mobile phone by about 10 to 1. It's not the best specification of all of the phones on the market, and it outsells all of the competitor brands combined. Now, that's quite a claim. I want you to consider that. Yeah, the most expensive product, and it outsells all of the other products. And I can tell you why, because of the time and effort that Apple have invested in creating an amazing customer experience. Apple are an incredibly easy company to deal with. They provide absolutely fantastic onboarding processes. They provide intuitive systems. They provide high levels of customer care. Their products are incredibly easy to access. They have absolutely fantastic post-sales service. Apple as an organization have invested a huge amount of time and effort in making sure that they have a customer journey that is of the absolute optimum. There are five very specific characteristics that exist for Apple that make them world class. Number one, they have a very diverse customer process. Whether you want to engage with them via written communication, via billboard in the street, whether you want to visit an individual person in a Genius bar, whether you would like a printed guide, whether you would like a downloadable application, every possible medium of communication is embraced by Apple. You can have written instructions in a booklet. You can download a YouTube video. You can have a hands-on demonstration by one of the individuals in the Genius bar. They make sure that as a customer, your experience is as diverse as possible and that you can engage with them in many and various ways. Think about this and compare it to your business. Can your customers access your organization effectively and diversely? Do you have a multi-faceted customer process that ensures that whatever stage your customers are at in the buying journey, they are able to access you quickly and easily in a medium that they enjoy? The second characteristic of a really high quality process is about timely engagement with your audience. Apple make very specific decisions about how regularly it communicates with its audience. It knows that if you go into a Genius Bar, they need to provide you with response within a minimum of 1 hour in order to maximise their customer service. And all of their team are engaged with that as an activity. They know that if you want response to customer care, that needs to happen effectively and quickly. They know that when you engage with one of their products online, there should be quick and immediate follow-up. They make very careful consideration of having timely responses. In your business, do you think carefully about exactly how regularly you should follow up? Do you have detailed timeframes in place for maximising the way in which you engage with people? Think about whether you have a customer experience that is timely and well planned. Thirdly, Apple have a well-defined set of expectations around how a customer is treated. When you become an employee of Apple as an organisation, they will set very clear expectations of exactly how an Apple customer should be engaged with. Too often, I see in businesses that individual business owners and managers give very little definition to how they expect their customers to be treated. They don't define the steps of the experience that a customer should take. So, depending on who you deal with in an organisation, you have a very different experience. A business needs to have complete control over the type of experience that a customer has with it, or it doesn't maximise its revenue. So start to think about these characteristics of an excellently powerful sales process and think about, are you underestimating what is required to create a proper growth strategy that drives the right number of people through your business? Fourth and very importantly is consistency. Whether you go into a Genius Bar in Ipswich or a Genius Bar in St. Ives, you will have a universally consistent experience. The customer experience is defined and it is implemented effectively. And there are tools to ensure that this happens in a very influential fashion. When you have a well-defined customer experience that is consistently implemented across your customer base, you win more clients. Has your business taken the time to understand exactly what set of activities leads to the most positive customer outcomes? And do you consistently replicate that? Are you confident that the customer experience that your customers are having at the moment is influential? Are you tracking and measuring your customer experience? Do you know when you go on a meeting whether that meeting converts effectively to business? Do you know with confidence the method by which you are proposing business is converting at the right rate? Do you know that your marketing activities are having a positive influence on buying decisions? If you have those five characteristics of diverse, timely, well-defined, consistent, and influential, you'll have a really powerful process. We're not even talking here about the sales interactions that you carry out. We're talking about the strategies, plans, and the processes that drive really effective customer experience in your business. So, powerful process, as delivered in a world-class way by Apple and their outstanding customer journey, is the first defining principle of having a world-class business. The second of the three pillars of the growth framework is about impactful activities. You might be starting to think now, where are the gaps in my business? How do I start to understand that? Well, great news. At the end of this webinar, we're going to give you the opportunity to take advantage of a hot seat, which will allow you to answer 15 very short questions and then to be given some very specific advice around which of the three defining areas your business needs to focus on to get more impact. So let's talk now about impactful activities. There's an organisation called Innocent Fruit Smoothies. I'm hoping you've heard of them. If not, I would definitely suggest you Google them very shortly. Innocent are a fantastic example of very considered customer communication. Customer communication to have real impact. So Innocent Fruit Smoothies was started in 1998 and they sold their business in 2013 for £320 million. I want you to think about this for a moment. three Cambridge University graduates set up a business in their back bedroom in 1998, and over the course of just over a decade, they created a £320 million business. Innocent are very aware that the communication that their suppliers, their customers, and their employees receive is of absolute primary importance to making a very successful business. Yeah? They have thought really hard about the style of communication that they use, the tone of voice that they use, and they've been true and consistent to that tone of voice in everything that they share with the world. And that has enabled them to build a brand that has outstripped their competitors. Think about the ways in which they communicate with their individuals. If you want to be part of the Innocent Fruit Smoothie community, you can join them on Facebook, where they have a really clear and strong tone of voice. They have a fantastic blog. They create amazing content. They hold festivals. They're an organisation who managed to get members of the public to knit hundreds of thousands of small hats for bottles of fruit juices just through their content marketing. Whether you are reading the side of one of their bottles or whether you are looking at one of their online blogs or their website, you will see a very consistent set of communications that powerfully impact on the way that they impact their market. And there are some key defining characteristics that are really key to having impactful activity. So number one is content. The guys at Innocent think about what they are going to say. They have really strong messaging. They share things that contain personality. They share things that are quirky. They define very clearly what they want the world to hear about them. They tell them not just about smoothies, but about how they feel about the world and about the personality of business. The structure of their communications. They think not just about the way they write a blog. They think about how they create individual interactions. Every year, they have a structured meeting where all of their suppliers get together, where they discuss the way in which individuals can supply more effectively to the organisation. They're constantly thinking about how they shape their activities. They have diversity. Whether you want to meet with them face to face at their fruit stock festival, or whether you'd like to read a book or a piece of literature, you're able to do so very effectively in a multitude of different ways. Whether you're laughing at the fantastic hats that are knitted on the shelf in your supermarket, or you're reading a really detailed white paper about environmental impact from one of the business owners on their website, you are able to access the organisation in diverse ways, and also the quantity of communication. They make sure that they are constantly front of mind. You would subliminally be engaging with their messages, whether through online, whether through physical materials, whether through television marketing. Innocent Fruit Smoothies, through PR, through communication, are impactful in the way that they share their information with you. I want you to think really carefully about the communication strategy you have in your business. Do you have a content strategy? Do you have structured communications that allow your message to be shared? Are you diverse in the way that you are championing your message to your clients? And do your customers see the right quantity of information? Having a very clear communications pillar within your business is part of the way that your business grows and is part of the way that you maximise the impact that you have when you're working with organisations. So think very carefully about whether critical principle number two of the growth framework is something that's going well for you in your organisation. So let's imagine you've got an amazingly powerful process and your customers are seeing world-class activity at that level. Let's imagine that your communication activities are so effective that your customers have telling exactly the right story about you all of the time. What is the third critical principle for a world-class business? Well, that's empowering management. And my case study for you around empowering management is an organisation called Google. Now, everybody has heard of Google, but perhaps what you won't know about Google is a little bit about how they're run from the inside. One of the reasons that Google has become the absolutely powerful, world-class organisation that it is, is because of the environment that it creates internally. For 6 years running, Google has been listed as Fortune America's top place to work. They've won awards for staff retention, and they break all of the industry norms. Now, anyone who has even recruited one member of staff will know that maximising staff retention is a massive challenge. Google have 53,000 employees. 53,000 employees. And they invest a huge amount of time into thinking about the happiness of those people. Google actually have a department which is called People Analytics, which is specifically designed to make life at Google better. To consider the hundreds of variables that impact on the life of the individuals and the relationships in that team. Because what Google recognise is that if the culture, the performance, the motivation, the engagement, the training and the development of a team is correct, then they will grow that business really powerfully. So the five critical principles and characteristics of empowering management are as follows. You have a really great structure. Everyone is clear about their roles and responsibilities, and they stick to those roles and responsibilities effectively and in a disciplined way. The business is resourced effectively. Everyone is right fit, right job, and they do what they need to do. And everyone is playing to their strengths. The business has clear performance standards. Everyone knows what their targets and goals are. We're all driving towards the best possible outcome for the business, and we're fixated on those goals. Really successful businesses know what their goals are and they act in accordance with them at all times. And they track and they measure and they assess. Really well-managed organisations have really effective communication. We talk consistently at team level, at individual level and at business level around what is being achieved and around how to achieve more and how to achieve better. I want you to consider in your organisation, when was the last time that you had a performance-related communication in your organisation? Do you meet regularly in a way that changes the way that people perform, in a way that enhances loyalty, in a way that drives people to be more successful? And the two final principles of a really high-performing management pillar in your business is good training and good culture. Are you investing in your people? Is there good development in place? Do you have a culture, an environment in which high performance thrives? Fantastic quote from the well-respected entrepreneur Richard Branson is that you should always look after your staff, because if you look after your staff, your customers will be taken care of. So why am I telling you all of this stuff? Well, the growth framework is the UK's only proven, measurable, holistic business growth tool. It doesn't just talk about selling. It doesn't just talk about how many customers we have. It talks about making sure your processes and practices are effective. It talks about benchmarking your organisation to understand how close you currently are to world class. The growth framework talks about making sure that your communications are effective. The growth framework talks about making sure your people are all performing to the maximum. The growth framework encompasses everything that is required to drive a good business. If you master the growth framework, you don't need to pull in experts from different areas. You don't need a finance consultant or a marketing consultant. You need to master one proven formula, the UK's award-winning growth framework, which will allow you to benchmark your business, to understand where you sit now in comparison to world-class organisations. It will allow you to then build a really effective growth plan and to assess that growth plan. People and businesses and individuals who master the growth framework learn to apply the critical principles of world-class businesses to their organisation. You will not only see a significant number of new customers and revenue, you will see a more efficient and effective business. You will see a business with people in it who are more empowered and are more loyal. The growth framework defines the build. building of a quality business. If you want to ensure that your business is breaking through all of its growth barriers and becoming the most powerful it can possibly be, embracing the framework is a key thing for you to do. So I want you to think about the three defining principles of a world-class business. Your sales process and customer journey, your sales activities and communication, and your management and culture. And I want you to think about where you think you sit. Are you already demonstrating the characteristics of a world-class business, or do you need more? The growth framework will teach you to benchmark your organization and understand where you sit currently. It will then teach you to build a growth improvement program that will cover all of the areas of development, and it will enable you to assess your organisation and to understand quickly what your barriers are for growth. It's the UK's most holistic way of growing a business. Every business who've applied it to their organisation has seen universal growth. So I'm working under the assumption that some of you might want to embrace this. How would you do that? Exciting news is the easiest way to do that is right now is to grab a hot seat session. We have a really cool diagnostic tool. It's 15 questions. You answer those 15 questions with the support of either myself or Emma, who is another sales guru working in our business and supporting business growth. If you want to do that free hot seat session, you just need to jump on and shout about it right now. You can do so through using the chat function, which you'll see on your drop-down list, or you can do so by doing a Q&A. What will happen in that hot seat session? You will answer 15 questions with either myself or Emma. You can do that by phone or by email, entirely up to you, however you wish to invest your time. From those 15 questions, we will zap you a very quick report that will tell you across process, activities and management, how you benchmark and what you need to do better. So jump on now. Thank you. We've already had our first person request that hot seat session. Emma and I only have time to deliver 5 hot seat sessions. So please jump on, find the chat or Q&A function here in the webinar. And you will be able to take advantage of that hot seat session. I'd like to thank the second person who has come forward onto the chat to take up that hot seat session. So that is the first thing you can do. Once you have done that hot seat session, you will then have the opportunity to download our ebook. You can do it instead of, it's better to do it as well as, because what the ebook will do for you is it will tell you very quickly exactly how you can start to solve some of those problems. So the hot seat provides you with your benchmarking and diagnostic. We've had 3 people now apply for that hot seat. If you would like to be among the 5 that get that hot seat session, jump on and let us know. You then can download the ebook. The ebook is totally free of charge. It will support you to start making some of these decisions about what characteristics are missing from your business that will shape a world-class organisation. If you decide, after completing our hot seat sessions and downloading our ebook, that actually you really want to master the growth framework for yourself, you need to join our Delegate Academy. The Growth Academy is a 90-day program that combines classroom sessions with videos, webinars, podcasts, and coaching calls that will allow you to master the growth framework for yourself. There are at the moment a selection of approximately 20 elite individuals who have mastered the growth framework, who actually have the skill to build a world-class organisation using this process. You could become one of them. We are doing 2 growth academies this year. If you want to really ensure that you are writing the plans and actions to drive a world-class business for 2020, you need to join us in one of those sessions. We've got one in the Southwest happening at our offices in South Gloucestershire on the 17th of September and running for a whole quarter of guided support. And we have another session beginning in Guildford. We've now had a third person get on board to request a place on our hot seat sessions. So if you'd like to explore how the growth framework could be applied to your business, please do jump on and accept that. We are going to invite everybody who has attended this webinar today to explore the Growth Academy and to understand what that might mean for you. So the actions that you need to take right now. Book a hot seat session. I've got four names so far. We do still have one place that we are able to offer. So please do speak up if you would like that. Download the ebook. Any one of you listening today can go to that ebook page and download that ebook. That will allow you to understand the five characteristics of each of the different principles. And finally, I'd like to invite you to join our Growth Academy. Following this, you will have an opportunity to look at testimonials from the individuals that have joined our Growth Academy. This is about mastering the UK's most effective business growth framework and becoming skilled in building a world-class business of your own. So there's been a lot of information for you guys to take on today. We've had businesses who have yet to even begin their business journey join us on the Growth Academy, and we've had organisations as large as Sky and their national sales manager join us. The important thing is we are wanting to build a network of business owners who are serious about building a world-class business, who want to come and master these skills. So we're going to encourage you now. We've got a few final moments to jump in and let us know if you would like. Emma will be in contact with you to book that session. Do so by email or telephone to ensure that you do get the chance to make sure that we cover off everything that you need to cover off to benchmark your business, to apply the growth framework to your organisation, to be one of the many businesses in the UK who have seen transformational growth by applying the UK's leading business growth tool. So as ever, I'm Karen Dunne-Squire. Absolutely delighted to have had so many of you listen to us today. There's loads of different ways that you can get in contact. If you're serious about building a business that consistently smashes its growth expectations, you need to master the growth framework. Make sure you stay in touch with Emma and I about how. We'll make sure you get a recording of this webinar, and I encourage you to continue to build on your world-class aspirations. I'm going to stay online for a few moments now. If any of you have any private chat questions you'd like to run by me, please do so. In the meantime, have an amazing day. Thanks for listening. I'm going to stop the video now and let you enjoy the rest of your day. Please send any comments or questions to me. And thanks very much for listening.